Praise be to Jesus Christ. Before we start today's class, let me ask you a question. Are you a Christian? If your answer is yes, then let me ask you another question. What is the literal meaning of the word Christian? The word Christian means follower of Christ. Can you follow someone whom you do not know well? Do you really know Jesus? If your answer is no, then Word of God is the solution for you. Today, we are going to learn the importance of Word of God in Christian life. Let us start our class with a prayer. Please recite this prayer along with me. Heavenly Father, who through the power of Holy Spirit caused all Holy Scripture to be written for our learning, we pray that we would diligently study your word and put it into practice so that we may receive the knowledge of salvation and understanding of your will for our lives. Open the eyes of our understanding and prepare our hearts by the power of your Spirit that we may receive your word with much joy and have a deeper understanding of who you are. May we be like Zacchaeus, have a conversion of heart, and like the Samaritan woman, transform ourselves after heeding to the word and proclaim to others. May we be filled with the grace of your Spirit that we may lead a life according to the precepts of your gospel. Unfold to us the precious truth that are contained within your words. We ask this through the special intercession of Saint Augustine and Saint Francis Xavier, who experienced a transformation in their lives when they surrendered themselves to the Word of God. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear students, do you want to be brothers and sisters of Jesus? If your answer is yes, then let us recollect an incident from the life of Jesus. He was teaching to a very big crowd, and then his mother and his brothers came to him. But they could not reach him because of the crowd. And he was told, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside wanting to see you." But he said to them, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" "My mother and my brothers are who hear the word of God and do it." Students, have you noticed the importance Jesus gave to listening to the word of God and following it? Those who listen to the word of God and follow it are raised to the status of family of Jesus. They are considered like mother of Jesus. They are considered like brothers and sisters of Jesus. Do you want to maintain a personal relationship with Jesus and share the salvation he has offered us? The salvation he gained through the passion, death and resurrection. The simplest way to achieve it is again through a word of God, by listening to what he has taught and following them in our lives. Human beings like us, with our limited brain and capacity, cannot understand most of the divine mysteries or external truths, such as who God is, how he interacts with us, and even how we can reach God. So, what did God, who is eternal love, do for us? He decided to reveal the mysteries and external truth for us. And how does God do that? God speaks to us through the Bible. Reading and studying Bible can help us understand all the external truths, such as who God is, how he interacts with us, and how we can reach him. Students, do you know the mysteries that we celebrate in Holy Qurbana? The mysteries that we celebrate in Holy Qurbana include the mystery of Holy Trinity, the Messianic mystery, the sacraments, and the life of resurrection. These mysteries are the principles of Christian faith. and all of these are revealed through the word of God. Let us see what is the teaching of the Second Vatican about importance of Bible. It says, the church venerates the Holy Bible just as the sacred body of Christ is venerated, because it is through the Holy Bible the Heavenly Father looks at his children with immense love and converses with them. The power of might of the Word of God are very great. It provides the church with support and vigor. It supplies the necessary faith to her children and food for her souls. So students, tell me, what did you understand from this? It means that Word of God is equally important as body of Christ. In the Holy Mass, we partake in the breaking of the word and breaking of bread. This again emphasizes the fact that receiving Word of God is as important as receiving the body of Christ. Let us now look into some references to importance of Word of God from the Bible itself. In 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 23, Saint Peter teaches us as follows. You have been born anew, not of perishable but of unperishable seed, through the living and enduring Word of God. Students, what did you understand from this? It means that Word of God has an important place in Christian life. It remains the foundation of our life. In John chapter 8, verse 51, Jesus says, very truly I tell you, whoever keeps my word will never see death. It means that those who listen to the word of God and live accordingly will be saved. In John chapter 6, verse 63, Jesus says as follows, it is spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words I have spoken to you are the spirit and life. Here, Jesus is telling us that word of God are the spirit and life. So those who follow the word of God with faith, love and prayer will have divine life. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 25, Jesus says as follows, everyone who hears the word of God and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on a rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on the house, but it did not fall because it had been founded on the rock. What did you understand from this? It means that whoever listens to his words and act on them develops a strong foundation of faith that will not shake when various challenges affect our life. Again in Matthew chapter 7, verses 26 to 27, Jesus says as follows, everyone who hears the word of mine and does not act upon them will be like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against the house, and it fell, and great was its fall. These are the people who fail to defend their faith when they face challenges in life. In 1 Maccabees, we can read that we have as encouragement the holy books that are in our hands. In adverse circumstances, Word of God would embark strength and even provide inspiration and encouragement. The more you read the Bible and more you memorize the Word of God, the better you can defend your faith irrespective of the challenges you face in your life. Let me ask you a question. Do you want to be a disciple of Jesus? Wait, before you answer that, let me ask you another question. Do you really know the difference between a follower and a disciple? A follower is a person who comes after the first person and does what the first person has did. But a disciple is someone who learns from a master or a teacher and then follows the master and even teaches others. A disciple passes on the teachings of the teacher. A true disciple fulfills the wishes of his master. A true disciple will lead a life according to the teachings of his master. 12 apostles were the first of the disciples of Jesus. Now tell me, do you want to be a disciple of Jesus? If your answer is yes, then Bible shows you the path. In John chapter 8, verse 31, Jesus says as follows, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples." Hence, to become a true disciple of Jesus, we must be rooted in the word of God. As we learned earlier, a true disciple fulfills the wish of his master. But how can we know the wish of Jesus? It is through the word of God. God reveals his wishes through the sacred word. The word of God is the wish of God about man. The discipleship of Jesus is the sharing of his individuality. A life according to his teachings is real discipleship. We must realize this discipleship through our ordinary life and activities. Remember what Jesus says in Matthew chapter 7 verse 21. "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven." So dear students, tell me, how do you plan to realize this discipleship in your life and activities? Have you ever felt the need for a change? Have you ever felt that you are not able to make that change? Answer to your problems is again word of God. Let us see some examples from the lives of Zacchaeus and the Samaritan woman. Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through, and a man named Zacchaeus was there. He was short, and he was a tax collector, and he was also rich. He wanted to see Jesus, but because of the crowd, he could not see because he was also short. So he ran ahead and climbed upon a sycamore tree and waited for Jesus to come. When Jesus came to his place, Jesus looked up and asked Zacchaeus to come down and take him to his house. Zacchaeus not only invited Jesus to his house, but also to his heart. He told Jesus that he will share half of his possessions to the poor. And he also told Jesus that he will give back 4 times of anything he has defrauded from anyone. Let us now hear the story of a Samaritan woman who came to take water from the well and met Jesus there. The Samaritan woman believed in Jesus and talked about him to many people, and all of those people got transformed. Therefore, if you listen to the word of God and believe it and follow it in your life, you will get transformed. Let me give you a small activity. Meditate about how you can realize the discipleship of Jesus through your life and activities. List down 5 activities that you will start doing from today to realize the discipleship of Jesus through your life. Let us again thank God for this opportunity to be part of this class and learn about the importance of Word of God in Christian life. Thank you. God bless us all. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.